welcome for Lynne and Linnette.
So this is a concert tour of my new CD, Life Stages, and most of the songs we're doing are on the Life Stages CD, but we're not doing all the songs on the Life Stages CD because there are 20, and so we're doing a portion of those. And the reason why I called the CD Life Stages was I've written songs over time since in my early 20s and even in my teens, and a number of them are on other CDs, but there were some songs that just didn't fit the other CD themes. And so I was writing songs about this most recent stage in our life with our aging parents, and so my husband suggested Life Stages. That's a really good title, I like that. And, you know, of course there's All the World is a Stage, and who knows who wrote that? That's a Shakespeare quote, yeah, from As You Like It. And the soliloquy goes on to talk about all the stages of life, and so I like that juxtaposition of the stage of a theater and the stages of life. So I wrote a song, so this is now the title track of Life Stages, and we're going to do that for you first. We're young and full of hope, and we can't wait to be full grown. We try to prove our worth and be the best the world has known. And in a while, the little child within us starts to fade. We step out in the spotlight onto another stage. Life has many stages. We travel through each one while time keeps turning pages until the story's done. Again, the seasons spin into another year. We leave behind the upward climb. Retirement is here. Life has many stages. We travel through each one while time keeps turning pages until the story's done. Each year and every age is just as precious as the last, and it goes by fast. when I went to my 30-year high school reunion, I actually helped out beforehand, helping to find some of our classmates and met with the committee. And when I first walked into the committee meeting, they said, "Who are you?" So I wrote the song and played it at my 30-year high school reunion. Some of you won't remember me. Hey, I don't remember some of you, but we all remember the way we were and each event we were part of. Now we've all got our own direction, but we've come here for reconnection. Now we can look at each other and say, "You're at the heart. You're at the heart of me. You're at the start of my history. You are a part of a mystery that makes me who I am. You're at the heart of me. You're at the start of my history. You are a part of a mystery that makes me who I am." Always this fast walker, and I never could keep up with him. And now, well, not so much. So this is a song called "I Wanna Walk With You." I remember redwood trees, hiking trails, and scabby knees. Trying to keep up with Daddy's lengthy stride. I remember running fast. Daddy turned around at last, watching me as breathlessly
enough to match my daddy's rapid pace. Now I tower over him, speed along with lengthy limb. Daddy calls out to me, where's the race? Daughter, slow down. My legs are weak, but yours are strong. Daughter, slow down, I want to walk with you.
It was because when I wrote this song, I was thinking, how am I going to get to 10 years from now? I wish that I could come back in time and tell me how to do it.
Thank you. cherish every step of the way. And drop a baggage, travel lightly, start all over, reach on it brightly. And that you could be wrong when you think you might be. Don't worry about today. Hey, drop a baggage, travel lightly, start all over, reach on it brightly. And that you could be wrong when you think you might be. Don't worry about today.
Once again, this is a song that is not on the Life Stages CD, but Linnette and I performed together as a duo. We're called Silverwood, and we started out when I was not playing harp many, many years ago. I played guitar, and she played flute, so we had silver and wood. Unfortunately, when I started up on the harp, we could keep the name. Also, Linnette is playing on a much larger flute now. This is called an alto flute. And it has a lower range and a nice sultry voice, perfect for some jazz. So we're going to do a little, it's actually a Latin tune that has become a jazz standard. Many people know it as Black Orpheus, but its original title is Manhã de Carnaval. And it's got Portuguese words, and the meaning of the Portuguese words are morning, what a beautiful morning of a happy day that I arrived. The sun came out in the sky, brilliant in every color, and brought the dream back to the heart. And this happy day, after this happy day, I don't know if another day will come. And our morning, so beautiful it was, Carnival morning. So we'll do a flute first, and then I'll sing it in Portuguese, and I will then sing it in English, with the English version, which is slightly different than the translation.
Thank you.
Pushing a button to get our meals fully cooked, you know, not just these, you know, microwave out of the freezer things, and many, many other things that I figured that they had promised me by the 1980s. So I wrote a song.
Way back in the 60s, when I was just a girl, we learned in school.
For about 10 or 11 years. And the song's called About 10, 11 Years. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to give my voice a little break and do an instrumental.
Thank you.
harp music now. One of the things that has happened in the last 5 or 10 years here, more like I guess 5, is I used to have my dad come over and help me on the computer, and now I just go and help him on the computer. And he would introduce me as the daughter. This is my oldest daughter. I used to help her on the computer. Now she helps me. And he was very proud of that fact. We moved into his senior living facility. And he would introduce me that way. And then, you know, he's now in the memory unit, so you'll be hearing a little bit more about that. But this song is what I wrote when he said, made those kinds of comments. And it made me think about how things are changing. Actually, a book's called The Harp Newbies, and it's beginning harp and then Harp Newbies Level 1 takes you up to a certain number of notes and rhythms and concepts. Harp Level 2 is called Not Quite Harp Newbies, and the third level is called No Longer Harp Newbies. And in the No Longer Harp Newbies book, I have written all these little pieces, and they became more and more big pieces. But this one was a cute little piece, and I thought it needs a title. So I called it A Jig in Your Pocket. And since I titled it, then the tune was in my head, and I kept coming up with more and more lyrics. So now it's a song. So you're going to listen to me singing, and then Lynette and I will play it together, and then we'll all sing it together this summer.
A jig in your pocket to pull out full of fun, and to share with all your friends at the setting of the sun. With flute and with fiddle and even with drums, you can play this little tune till the morning light comes. And when the night's over and daylight appears, you can put it in your pocket and dry up all your tears. And when you would like to replay it again, you can put it in your pocket and call up a friend.
We have a nice referral service that anyone can call into a number and they can get music in their room. The patients call, their family members, nurses, doctors, spiritual care, physical therapists, and anyone can call. And so I've been playing a lot for the last, actually it's going to be 16 years in August that I've been doing this. And in one shift I might see 6 to 8 people. And everyone's at a different stage, but some are going to go home soon, some are not going to go home. But I noticed a really big difference when the patient has someone who's a very special caregiver, spouse, child, a parent, a good friend, someone there every time I'm there to play. It makes such a difference to the experience of being in the hospital. So I've been wanting to sing a song for the caregivers. And there wasn't a good one, so I wrote one. So what we're going to do is we'll play a little bit of one of the tunes that I do play quite a lot for patients. Celtic music is so soothing and uplifting at the same time. So we're going to start with a tune called Shebeg Shemor that a lot of people, I think, know. And then I'm going to morph into my song that I wrote for the caregivers. Sip some water. Thank you.
like to be instead. They tell me I am brave, but I know it's really you, 'cause you don't have to be here, but you choose to be. I sleep most of the time. You sit beside me now, watching numbers drop and climb. They tell me I am strong, but I know it's really you, 'cause you don't have to be here, but you choose to. You realize I know the price you're paying by staying by my side, and I hope you know that I know what you do. When you don't have to be here, but you choose to, they give me medication of pain. Well, you are feeling powerless to make it go away. My friends all wish me well, they should wish the same to you, 'cause you don't have to be here, but you choose to. Just come and hold my hand, listen while I, though I'm not the greatest company, I hope you realize I know the price you're paying by staying by my side, and I hope you know I'm grateful that you do. Telling on you, don't forget, as you care for me, take care of yourself too. I know the price you're paying by staying by my side, and I hope you know I love you, and I know you love me too.
About it, my cousin, our cousin actually, sent a photo of herself and of her mother, half and half, merged together. And I said, ooh, cool, do it for me and my mom too. And she did, and I look just like my mother. So that's what inspired this next song. It's called A Parent in Me.
I was such an odd kid, never fitting in. Now I see how much there is of mother and how much of father I carry deep within. Don't get me wrong, I'm still an individual, still some residual unique qualities. What more and more I see in their eyes, no smile, hair, what I say, what I wear. Parents are apparent to me. decision and my some revision of my mom and dad. Don't get me wrong, I'm still an individual, still have some residual unique qualities. What more and more is he a mere eyes, nose, smile, hair, what I say and what I wear. Parents are a parent
because I just had this concept of what I wanted the songs to sound like, and so rather than bringing other people in, I just did it all myself. But then what happens is that it comes down, well, which song, which instrument should I use for these? And I might have used piano, but these next three also had guitar as a primary instrument. So you're going to hear all these on guitar. The first one here, is a song that I wrote within the week before my mom passed. And I wanted to write her a song. I'd never done that. And she was in the hospital, and I wrote the song one day and recorded it with piano and vocal and put it on my iPhone and took it with me to the hospital, and I was able to play it for her. So she was able to hear the song, but it's a tribute to my mom. And it's called Picture of Me. I'll make sure my guitar is on too.
Your beautiful smile, the window of your heart, curtains pulled wide open, shines light into the dark, the love in your eyes, as deep as any sea.
through it. Now that we got through it, today is the anniversary of my mom's death. And we weren't sure we could play this song, but we did, so. And we're following it up with a very happy song, but it has a story as well. All my songs have stories. I still am a voice teacher, but I was working at a music store as a voice teacher, and this guy walked into my studio, and I thought, oh, he's here for some voice lessons, and he didn't come in with an instrument, so it must have been voice. And he said, no, I want you to write me a song, a hip country song, so I can become a star. He didn't need vocal lessons, or he was sure he didn't, and I said, well, I don't write songs on demand, and I don't write country songs in particular, I just don't. And so he went away, probably found someone else to write him a song, but on my way home, I'm going, yeah, right, find me time and I'll write you a song. And I ended up, by the time I got home, I had most of this song written. But I didn't give it to him. I kept it for myself. Find me time to do it and I'll write a song for you. With a fiddle in back playing sweet the whole way through. A mandolin and a cup on the beat, holding down the rhythm and carrying the beat. Find me time to do it and I'll write a song for you. She kept telling me, go help your dad, he's in the computer room, and he just doesn't come out of there. He goes in and never comes out. And so I just got so much to catch up on. So I went in there, and he had stacks and stacks of mail. and it was all male asking for money and asking for his response. And being the gentleman he is, he felt he needed to respond to each and every one of those. There were probably about five piles of mail, this high, literally. And I started going through them with him. I said, Dad, you don't need to give this. You don't need to give to all of these. You don't need to write a check for every piece of mail that comes in. And it was very hard for him to give that up. Mm-hmm. So this is what I believe is a form of elder belief. This is a form of elder abuse that not a lot of people know about. And you know, it's, you don't know what's happening with your parents because you're not there, you know, and watching how many checks he's writing to these organizations. Many of these organizations I believe were phoned to. So anyway, I just wrote a song about this, partly just to kind of bring awareness to this issue. It's called Bleeding Heart. Hospital, there's that, but also it's really fun to try and make things work on the harp. You know, it's an instrument that's limited because it has one key at a time. So you hear one scale. If you want notes that aren't in the scale, you have to flip levers and set levers fancy, and you know, to get the more bluesy stuff. But I still love to play guitar. I still love to play piano, violin, all the other instruments. Oh, I need to turn some pages here, don't I? There we go. But this is one that's a very typical tune to hear on combination of harp and flute, or maybe fiddle, but it's on our Silverwood CD. It's a standard Celtic tune called King of the Fairies. Mm-hmm. Sure, I have the one funny, the one funny one was right. Yeah. Okay. We finally had to have his memory checked, and yes, he does have dementia, and it's Alzheimer's. Mm. He does still know us, and that's really cool. We go to visit him, and he knows who we are, and he tells everybody around him. These are two of my daughters. That was something he said recently. There's only two daughters. Two of my daughters. He does have two sons as well. And he's still just the sweetest man, and everybody loves him. So we're really very, very grateful that his experience with dementia is not as bad as it could be. So when he was diagnosed, I wrote this song for him. And I wrote it, I want to also say that I wrote it from all of his kids' perspective as opposed to just from me. A lot of the songs, it's very self-centered. I say I and me, but this one is from us kids to my dad.
We'd like to spend some time with you, doing things you'd like to do. Reminisce about when we were children. Go to movies or the zoo. Watch a sunrise fade to blue. Share our dreams and how we hope to build them. And all you need to do is to be who you are. The one that we all and adore. And should it be that you can't think of who we are, we'll love you just as much as before. We know how hard it is for you, giving up what you once knew, watching as the physical you. Muscles are stays true. And all you need to do is to be who you are, one that we all cherish and adore. And should it be that you can't think of who we are, love you just as much as before. So much more life to live. We'll be there to share it all with you. The future is unknown, but you'll never be alone. And when you wonder what you ought to do, well, all you need to do is to be
to. This is the last song before our, is that right? Before our encore. I wrote this one for my former supervisor at Stanford Hospital when she had a career change. So I wrote the song for her, and that's all I need to say about it.
Keep in touch.
Because it's on the other side of your song sheets. So I'm going to sing this first to you, and so you'll hear me saying, "May the coming year bring you peace," and you, as you see on your song sheet, it's going to be, "May the coming year bring us peace." So then we're going to all sing it together with the us's, with the singing with and for each other. When I wrote this song, I realized that the chord progression sounds an awful lot like the Pachelbel canon in D, and many, many songs have that chord progression, so it's not really stealing, but I decided to kind of give a little Pachelbel-ish interlude. So we'll sing, I'll sing for you once, we'll sing it all together, then we'll play a little interlude, and we'll finish off the song with the second half of the page again.
Most of all, may love.
you won't be far away. This may be a bit cliche. Keep in touch, there is much we still can share.